Yo, what's good? It's your boy St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com, checking out a new library from Soundiron called Apocolypse Percussion Ensemble. It's just a really dedicated library to cinematic, epic, trailer-type percussions. So, let me show you what's in it. There's $199. It requires a full version of Kontakt. We've got 14.3 gigabytes. It's a 7.3 gigabyte download. And there you can see you got snares, bass drums, toms. You can see all the stuff you got in there. And then you got the solo drums as well. So you got the ensembles and the solos. It also has some ambiences in there. So I got it pulled up right here. Right now I have the close ensemble loaded. And you can see you got ambiences, masters, mics free, and then the mixed. So we'll go through a few of the different ones. This is the close ensemble. It has everything in it. I'm going to just play it. You can see it has a really great sound to it. Now, as you can see, I got my filters. I can do EQ, I can do a filter if I want. And then you got EQ. You also got convolution reverb in there, so you can mess with that. Let's say I want to turn my convolution on. I can mess with either effects convolutions, or I can mess with spaces. Let's like load an iron door. Mess with a, I don't know, what's a metal lid. Just so you can hear the difference. If I turn it back on. You got a lot of stuff in there that you can mess with. Or you can choose different spaces, let's say a stairwell. Also cathedral. You get the idea with that one. Let's get that out of there and let's mess with this one here. This is the far. It's the same ensemble, but it's just the far version. And then you got this little, what they say, uber arpeggiator. It's basically like an arpeggiator. You can turn it on and so it sounds awesome just by pressing, you know, some of the different instruments. You can go in and mess with it, change the steps, stuff like that. So we got that. And then let's go back in here. You see you got the different ones. You got light, high memory, or the direct from this. I'm just loading the direct from this one's just to, so it doesn't take forever to load. So let's see what else we got in here. We got some mixers. These are actually cool. Check out this mega mixer. I really like the interface on this. So this allows you to make your own ensemble. However you want it to be laid out, you can load the instruments, just the instruments that you want to load. So alright, so as you can see, I got a little TV-like window for each one. I can load whatever I want in each one of these, and it shows up down here. The red shows me which one I'm editing right now. And I got a mixer, so. And I can mess with the stuff down here, the pan, the dynamics, the tuning. can set the key range. Say I want to change it and put that in there. So you can go through and just build whatever you want. So I thought that was pretty cool. Like I said, you got a close and a far mega mixer, so that has everything in it. You can go in, you can adjust the volume of each, you know, each sound and everything. So it's really, really cool. And this one still has the convolution in there, and you still got the EQ and the filters and stuff like that. And then you got these smaller mixers where it's just individual instruments. Let's say we got a bass drum ensemble mixer, so it has all the bass drums in there. These you can't actually change, but you can still, you know, mix them and mess with the volume, pan, the stepping, which is kind of like the tuning. So let's say. So you can see, you kind of get the idea there. And again, you still got your EQ and your convolution there. So there's a lot of stuff in here. I just want to show you the different way that they got them laid out. Let's check out let's check out the ethnic. So you got the ethnic instruments in there, ethnic percussions. And then also remember you got the solo. So here's the ethnic solo mixer. Key range has the different instrument and a different range. Still got the convolution. So I want to turn on the garage. So you get the idea with that. Let's see. You got let's look at, check out one of the snares. Let's look at the snare ensemble. So it just, it has a really, really, really good sound. They really did a great job on the recordings. Then you have the mics free, which lets you load each mic position. So let's say I want to load the cymbal ensemble with mic A. So if you just want to play the specific, you know, mic position. And this one still has the arpeggiator, the uberpeggiator, I guess that's how you say it, convolution, and so they all have the same, you know, performance stuff, and then the EQ convolution and the uberpeggiator, whatever. So it's if you just want to play the specific. So that's what the mics free means. It means, you know, you got the individual mic position laid out in the instrument. Again, let's try one more of these. Let's check this one here. So if you just want to play the close, or you want to play the far, then you got the actual, let's check out some of the solos. And show you any of those. Same thing, but it's just with the solos. So let's say I want a solo. Let's do a tom. High tom. Solo. So as you'll see when we go into the mic section, some instruments have three mics, some of them have two. It just depends on how they felt the instrument sounded best. Some of them sounded best with three mics, some of them sounded best with two. So. Some of them have an extra, it's like a mid-wide, it's like a mid-channel, but it's wider than the close. So then you got the far, close, and then the, here's a close, wide, and the far and different stuff like that. So you get the idea there. And then let's go into the mics. So you got the mics mixed. What this does is let you mix the mics yourself. So let's say I want the bass drum ensemble. And you can see this one has a 3-mic mixer. So it's going to have all three different mics. You can see the mics right here. If I want to turn them down, you can hear the difference. There's mic B. And then there's mic C. So I can mix them however I wish. Maybe I want to turn this one down a little bit. Sounds great. Maybe I want to turn on the uberpeggiator. Idea with that. Let's check out. Here's one with a 2-mic. Really, really love the sound. Again, adjust the mic levels. Let's check out some of the ambiences. So, well, let's do one of the couple of the solos first. Check out a snare. Got the mics on there. So close mic is turned all the way up, but maybe I want to turn that down. Turn this one up. Let's get the idea with that one, and let's look at the frame break. You can see this one has 3 mics. Let's turn this one up a little bit. Maybe turn this one up too, get more of a... Alright, so, and then you also got the ambiences, which are actually pretty cool. This one right here allows you to, like, mix. So you got 2 layers. You can mix which ambiences you want to listen to. And it's all made from the same samples, so from the same percussion samples. Just let's say I want ambience 3. And I can mess with the blend right here. So that's really awesome. And maybe I want this one here. It was just some cool stuff, and then you can, or you can load each individual ambience if you want. So that's just like getting some extra pads that when you normally wouldn't even expect to get that in the library like this. Awesome stuff. And then you got the where I put that at. It comes with some bonuses, the snare rolls that they added. So let's check out some of these. I mean, sure, you can make your own, but having actual snare rolls captured gives you much more realistic sound. So you got that one, and then you got the mics mixed. So that was the free mics, but then if you wanted to mix your own mics, it's two mics, as you can see. I can go in, mess with those. Get that with it as well. So not only get all the percussions, you get the ambiences, which is really cool, but you also get these bonus snare rolls. And like I said, I like the fact that you can go in. I really like this one right here, the little mega mixer, because you can make your own ensemble and choose just the instruments you want, mix them and match them, stuff like that. Like I said, giving you control over all the different areas, you know, having the instruments where you can mix the mics yourself, or if you just want to load them and have the mics, the mic position separated on the keys, you can do that. So you got ensembles and solos. This is a really, really, really great sounding library, and it's really, really fun to use. It's really easy to wrap your head around. It's really customizable, which is awesome. But the bottom line is it sounds great. So I really like that it has its own unique sound. I love the interface. I love how you can go in, mess around with the different stuff, tweak it, mess with the convolution, mess with the uberpeggiator, mess with the filters, all that different stuff. Love the ambiences, all this stuff, man. Definitely check this joint out. I'm gonna give this a 4.5 out of 5. It's a really, really dope library. Definitely suggest you check it out if you're just looking for a really nice collection of cinematic and epic percussions. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of percussion libraries out here. This one really stands at the top, in my opinion. Really based on the sound. If nothing else, the sound itself. Even if this didn't have all the interface and everything, if they just gave you the instruments as they are in those different sections with just the way that they sound awesome. But the fact that you can go in, change them, tweak them, you know, mix them, match them, do all that stuff, and then they threw in the ambiences and the snare rolls. Really, really dope library. Definitely check it out. This is your boy St. Joe. SoundsAndGear.com. Soundiron Apocolypse Percussion Ensemble. It's $199. Good price. Lots and lots of content, as you can see. And it's just, you know, it's really, really fun to play. Really sounds great. And they just did a great job on it, in my opinion. So definitely check them out and go on over there and see what else they got. Let me know what you think. It's your boy St. Joe. SoundsAndGear.com. Peace.